In not cool news.
It's not cool, bro.
Submitted by Asian Twinkie.
What's an Asian?
What? Oh, like yellow on the outside, white on the inside.
Oh.
Casey.
That's Casey.
Kind of.
Not really.
He has a yellow.
Casey's just a white person.
He's not a real Twinkie. He's just
actually white.
He's an egg.
I'm more Asian than Casey.
He's an egg?
See? At least I married an Asian lady. Like, his parents would be more proud of me. A YouTuber is being criticized after uploading prank videos of him throwing water in people's faces.
That's not even a prank anymore.
How do you feel about
this? Oh my god.
Well, it depends on the context. What's the joke?
Yeah, what is the joke?
Is the joke like, I don't know. I think I actually know what this joke is. Isn't it like, it's acid or some shit? Oh, fuck this
guy.
It
is?
Yeah, that's
the prank. He's saying it's acid, which is crazy.
Well, I don't actually, I can't confirm if he's saying it's acid, but he goes up to these people and he's like pretends to talk to them or whatever. He's holding water and he just throws it on their faces. But this is really fucked up because this all takes place in London, and the UK right now has the highest number of recorded acid attacks per person in any country in the world. So this is like a sensitive topic there, and this fool's going around doing this prank. So I'm gonna show you guys this video, a little clip of him doing his prank.
Is that a Subway cup?
Excuse me. I'm wondering,
He said, is it alright if I get you all wet?
It's funny shit, dude.
Oh my god, this guy's killing me. He's hilarious. He's a natural talent. Wow. There's so much talent.
He's a comedian.
Oh man, he works so hard for his comedy.
See, that's what I don't get. It's like when everyone was digging the Tom Cruise water microphone thing. Remember that? When Tom Cruise was getting interviewed and then some guy like squeezed the microphone and water came out and he's like, hey man, you know, it's not cool, man. Tom Cruise like, hey, buddy, it's not cool, bud. Or whatever that was. Like, and people were like, oh great, yeah, you got Tom Cruise. And I'm like, that's an asshole move. Like, what's the joke?
Yeah, I don't know what the joke is.
That's Tom Cruise, you look like an idiot with water all over your face. You fucking idiot.
Or it's like, oh, he's human now. He also hates when he gets water in his face.
Right, or like if I took this coffee here and I just dumped it on Tiff and I'm like, it's a prank. And she's like, oh, and I'm like, why are you reacting like this? It's just a prank.
Is it okay to attack him if he attacks you? Like, is it considered self-defense?
Yeah.
Well, maybe not in the UK, because in the UK you can't even say certain shit without getting fucking arrested.
Really?
Yeah, dude. I heard that people were literally, there was a story a couple days ago where people were reading Winston Churchill quotes. And because some of those quotes are considered anti-Islamic, they got in trouble.
But they're Winston Churchill.
That's right, Winston Churchill quotes. The guy has statues all over that place.
Wow.
It's crazy, man.
That didn't look like a acid prank. It was just like a stupid douchebag throwing water prank. But are people scared because
they think
there's so many like
fear? They're on high alert.
Yeah, exactly. So they're like, no, I'm getting acided.
Yeah, it's probably the social context.
Where do people get acid?
Amazon, apparently.
Oh, really? What kind of acid is it?
I don't know.
I mean, I guess it's...
Because the only kind of acid I know is the one that's for $5 and you get real fucked up.
Is it only $5?
Yeah.
Wow.
Really? $5?
What about the...
One little paper thing.
Stop making it so enticing.
Or if you go to a rave and you want liquid, you pay the acid man $5 and he goes, chip, and he puts it in your tongue.
Technically, vinegar is acid.
What is it used for? To clean, like, car parts and shit?
Vinegar?
No, acid. Oh. What is it used for?
Vinegar's for dumplings.
Remember Breaking Bad?
Heisenberg. To burn bodies, right? Yeah, no, I just want to know.
Have, like industrial uses.
There's hella uses for all.
Yeah, because you go to Home Depot or whatever and you buy the acid because you need to do like things around the house or some shit.
Yeah. I
don't even know what to do with it.
We should ban it since you don't use it.
Yeah. Why would we need it for?
Yeah. That's what I think.
Can't use it, Ben.
They should limit how many acids for people's pockets.
Right now, I looked it up, and they're saying that there are between 15 to 20 different substances that are being used in these acid attacks. So, like bleach or chemical irritants, or
oh no,
they're saying like anything you find in a kitchen cupboard.
Oh no.
Do they know the source of these acid attacks?
Pretty men. Or they like, I don't like this guy's face because he gets all the ladies.
Could be. Anyone else have a guess?
The source of these acids?
Yeah.
Who's doing them?
Like, I didn't even know it was a thing.
Where'd they come from all of a sudden out of nowhere?
That people just brainstorm acid attacks?
Yeah.
Maybe they're trying to recreate Two-Face from Batman.
Oh, that's probably where it was.
What do you got? It looks like you're...
Oh no, what does she got? I want to hear what she got first.
Well, what they're saying here is that this whole acid attack is not new to the UK. The first reported acid attack goes back to 1736, but the past year...
So it's an old-fashioned weapon.
Yeah, but they're saying that the past year that this has increased, and it's a divert from domestic violence into robbery and hate crime. That's what that says.
It's a hate crime?
Yeah.
So who's hating on who?
But I've read articles where this woman, like, she has, like, she's jealous of her boyfriend moving on, or her ex-boyfriend, and then she ends up attacking the new girl, or like things like that. Like,
so is it a lot of women jealousy?
That's crazy.
Well, I'm not saying it's all women jealousy. I'm just saying that's one example.
So, okay, so it's kind of like this. It's like, you know, the KKK's choice of hate crime is burning crosses or hanging people, right? So like, what gang or group is doing this? New phenomenon. That I'm just trying to figure out who the culprit is, because it sounds like a new thing that hasn't, like, gangs do drive-by shootings. It's not like the choice of crime for businessmen.
Well, they're also saying that they're using these acid attacks to like rob people. Or even these fake acid attacks where they'll pretend like, oh, this is acid, and throw it on the person, and they'll panic and they'll drop their stuff, but it's fake. But it's just that they're trying to rob these people, and they'll use that.
Damn. I'm not going to London.
What happened to the old-fashioned, like, pretending like you got a gun in your shirt type of thing?
Yeah, you gotta run around with a fucking cup of acid and shit, and it might pour back on you. That's dangerous.
It's not very convenient to walk around with a cup like that all day.
Well, no, what they're doing is they're putting it in bottles with lids, and then they'll put holes in the lid, and
oh no,
and it disfigures them for life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
If this happened, right, like if someone goes ha prank like that and you fuck them up in the U.S., will we get in trouble?
I don't really care. I'm doing it. I'm gonna fuck them up.
I feel like would, right? Would that be assault?
I mean, that's like more than assault, man. It's like fucking attempted. It's like, I think it's like attempted murder.
There's
or something.
People that died too.
No, but if they had water the whole time, they had water, but then they just spill it on you as a prank, but then you felt like your life was threatened, can you beat their ass?
I think so, because when you rob someone, like the good old fashioned fingers in the shirt thing, that's considered assault with a deadly weapon.
Oh, even though you don't have a weapon?
Yeah.
True.
Yeah.
Oh, like this? Yeah, like this?
If you rob a liquor store, like, give me your money, give me your money.
I'm gonna take all your money, see? Yeah, but I don't know. I think if I go to London, then I'm gonna be 24/7 with the Asian mom.
The visor.
Just have that on? You good, man.
I'll wear the white one that has the makeup already on it.
Oh,
that's funny.
What? You've never seen it? No. It's like in every like heist and fucking robbery movie.
Oh, that one. That one that we have. I thought you meant a visor that has makeup on it.
Though. Those ones have holes.
Oh, like the screen mask.
No, it's transparent.
It's trying to be like little children. It looks like little children.
Okay.
Oh, kind of like the Purge or something.
Yeah. Like those ones. Yeah, the Purge has those.
I know what you can wear now forever to not be a target. So go get one of those costumes from Disneyland or whatever, like, because no one attacks Mickey Mouse.
But that makes me laugh so hard to see those guys attacked. I know. Like, that was the best part of Ace Ventura, is when he kicked the shit out of that dolphin at the end.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Yeah. Oh my God, that killed me as a kid. In fact, at Disney, have you guys been to Disneyland and seen this Star Wars? Oh God, they have like a lightsaber school for kids. Like,
I know what you're talking about.
Come be a Jedi's thing.
Really?
Oh man, you gotta check it out, dude. It is a riot. If you're at Disney and your legs are freaking tired, right?
Yeah.
You go to the Jedi Academy's thing. You sit there. You get like your drink or whatever, right? And you're chilling there. And these kids, they come out with lightsabers, and they get attacked by like Darth Vader and stuff, and they start just fucking wailing on them.
Really?
It's like, yeah, they're like like really going for it.
And then the kids are like 100%.
Yeah, the kids are like 100% like trying to freaking kill the guy.
That's dope.
It's incredible.
One of those kids.
Oh, it's the best.
They put them up for the volunteer thing.
It's like a Jedi's is always has the trainings. A Jedi's always disciplined. A Jedi's is always, and then Darth Vader comes out and they're like.
Is he going 100% on the kids?
Like, that's awesome. Throwing the freaking lightsaber at the guy. Like, it's amazing, man.
Somehow I picture, like, there's always that one kid that keeps attacking the balls. Always attacking the balls.
I love it. I love teaching kids. I love trying to teach kids discipline while they just run amok after. It's amazing.
I like beating up kids.
What the hell did you just say?
for fun. For fun.
Just for fun. Oh, okay. Well, you. Thanks for clarifying.
I like airsofting, and one of my favorite things to do is shoot kids.
Oh, I can see that. Yeah, when I went paintballing, it was always fun.
It's so fun.
Yeah.
In the most positive way possible.
What if it's your kid?
Hey, he wanted
to play.
That's
even better. What kind of argument is that? That's way better.
He's not going to hold back.
Those kids are really good, though. Some of those groups of like 13-year-olds will
The paintball kids are like a SWAT team in there.
Yeah, they'll wreck adults.
I know, I even asked them, like, is someone organizing your groups and stuff? And, like, who brings you guys? Or, like, what's your team name or whatever? Like, no, we just come and we meet
They go so much that they're just really, really good.
Dude, that's like when I play laser tag, dude, because I play laser tag sometimes with my adult friends. How do you sell that one? And no, but there's always these little Mexican kids in there that destroy me.
Yeah.
They destroy me. And he just looks so nonchalant while they do it. They're like trained killers in there, man.
Yeah.
They've been doing it for years. Learning, adapting.
Overcoming.
You know what I mean?
That's their turf.
Yeah, right? They even do shit too where they like cover their packs in certain ways while they snipe you around the corner. Like, holy shit, they're good, man. I don't stand a chance in there.